Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create custom data object field merges and how to use them to pre-populate forms and personalize emails. Here's what I'll cover in this video. We'll start with a quick overview of custom data objects. Then I'll show you how to create a field merge with them and how to use the field merge in a form as an example. Let's get started. Your primary Eloqua contact record contains explicit data about contacts and accounts. The contact fields categorize information per contact or account record. There are default contact fields, such as first name, last name, and email address, as well as custom fields that you define. Custom data objects, also known as CDOs, custom objects, or data cards, store information that is not in your primary contact or account record. They are composed of custom object fields and custom object records. This data is stored in Eloqua, linked to your primary contact or account record, and made available for your marketing initiatives. For example, you might have a CDO called Subscription Renewal Information that includes CDO fields such as Renewal Product Name, Renewal Date, and Renewal Fee. If you include an email address field or another unique contact identifier that is also in your primary contact record, then you can link the CDO data to the contact data in a one-to-many relationship that extends the information you have about your contacts. Organizations use custom objects to extend their contact field limit, improve segmentation, targeting, and personalization by enriching their contact record data, managing data that is temporary or that changes frequently, such as promotion codes, detailed purchase history, and even preferences and subscriptions. They're also used to separate data, such as data collected by different business units. Imagine the possibilities for using CDOs in your marketing. With all of these potential data types and values in your custom objects, imagine how many opportunities you'd have to use the data, whether to personalize emails or pass actionable data to Eloqua in hidden form fields. So let's take a look at how to create the field merges that pull data from custom objects into fields in forms, emails, and landing pages. In order to create a custom object field merge, you need at least one custom object. Whether you need to find one or create one with the fields you need, you can access the custom object area from the audience menu. I see that we have a custom object called Survey Options and Results. I can click this arrow and select Custom Object Record field to view the CDO fields it contains. As you can see, the Survey Options and Results CDO has a Satisfaction Score field, which is exactly what I was looking for because I want to send anyone who gave us a score of 0 to 5 out of 10 in the survey to be added to an Eloqua Nurture campaign. Now that we know we have the survey score data in a custom data object, let's create our field merge to capture that data. On the Assets menu, I'll go to Components and click Field Merge. The New button opens the Field Merge Configuration window. This is where we select the type of field merge we want to create, name it, and configure it. I'll call it 2017 Survey Score Low. A default value is what, if anything, you want to be displayed in the field merge if the custom object has no data to display for a contact. We can leave it blank. The Merge From drop-down list is where I identify the type of field merge I want to create, so I'll select Custom Object Fields. I'll identify the custom object, which is called Survey Options and Results. I'll also identify the custom object field that holds the data I want, which is the satisfaction score. And, in case a single contact has completed the survey more than once, I'll narrow the results to a single value by selecting Last Created. Now this is where it gets interesting. The remaining settings are optional. They let you set criteria to filter the data captured by the field merge. Remember, we don't want all of the satisfaction score data. We want to know which form submitter scored us lower than 5 on the satisfaction scale. So in the optional criteria area, I'll select the satisfaction score field again, because that field contains the data I'll build my filter conditions on. Next, I'll define the conditions for the data I want this field merge to capture. To capture scores only if they are less than 5, I'll select between and specify the score range I'm interested in, and then I can save. That's all there is to creating and saving a custom data object field merge. The next step is to use the field merge, whether to personalize emails and landing pages, or to pre-populate forms. Let's see how we can use it in our satisfaction score scenario. Remember that our plan was to put our unsatisfied customers into a nurture campaign. We could start the campaign with an email that actually quotes the score the contact gave us. All we need to do when we create the email is add the field merge wherever we want to display the score given by a specific customer, like this. We could also use the field merge in a form for next year's survey if we wanted to show contacts their previous year's rating, for example. The pre-population tab for this text field in next year's form lets me select the 2017 survey score field merge. As with the field merge I added to the email in the previous example, it appears highlighted in yellow after I add it to the form. Here are some tips before I go. When you create custom object field merges of your own, give them descriptive names that identify their CDO and provide some indication of the data they capture and display. Watch the video about form processing if you're using field merges in your forms. Subscribe to this channel and check back often for more information on field merges and custom data objects. And of course, see the KnowIt page on Topliners. Happy field merging. Thanks for watching.